Thank you for the introduction, and thank you for trying my demo in previous session. I am Kazuyuki Fujita from Tohoku University, Japan. I'm going to talk about the work, Sayasuite, more in detail. This work is also done by Mentin Fan, Kazuki Takashima, Taichi Tsuchida, Hiroyuki Manabe, and Yoshifumi Kitamura. First, let me introduce a quick summary of this work. We propose a simple interface called Sayasuite, which introduces a rubber-mounted transparent seat with conductive material attached on a touch panel. This interface distinguishes between normal touch and tangential force input, depending on whether the seat moves or not, without requiring any external sensors or power. We explore a wide range of interaction techniques using this interface. Let me briefly talk about the background. Touch interaction has become a main input modality for most interactive devices, which provides intuitive user experience. However, the limitation of touch interaction includes its few input modalities and lack of physical feedback. This often becomes a problem when switching between multiple modes of operation, such as navigating in a map, drawing on a canvas, or playing a game. Many studies have tried to enrich touch interaction, and one popular approach is utilizing force as an additional modality. While many researchers have explored touch pressure force that is perpendicular to the surface, some works have also introduced shear force that is tangential to the surface. Since shear force has vector information that consists of pressure value and its direction, we believe it has potential to greatly extend touch interaction. There are several works that have introduced shear force input into handheld devices. Hale proposed a phone case-like device with 12 pressure sensors, but the limitation is the lack of physical feedback during shear force input. Harrison introduced a device whose touch panel surface physically slides using two analog joysticks. This mechanism provides physical feedback, but it requires major hardware modifications into existing touch panel. Nakai used a soft gel layer on the touch panel that can estimate shear force without any external sensors. But it does not distinguish between normal touch and shear force input. In summary, in spite of high potential for shear force input, previous works still have feasibility problems or lack of physical feedback. We believe solving these issues will make shear interaction more common and practical. Here, we focus on the characteristics of capacitive sensing. Some researchers have explored to extend the capacitive touchscreen by using conductive materials like this work. This idea is simple but quite useful because it requires no additional external sensors or power to introduce new input modalities. Thus, we introduce Sayasuite, a low-cost and electronics-free interface that enables shear force input by utilizing characteristics of capacitive touchscreens, and we expect it to make shear interaction more practical and flexibly designable. The main idea of Sayasuite consists of two features. First, we install a rubber-mounted transparent seat overlaid on the touch surface that can be physically moved to a certain extent in two dimensions when shear force is applied. Second, the seat has a tiny conductive tape on its underside, so the seat's movement can be detected as touch input by the touch panel when it is grounded by the user's hand. This mechanism achieves shear force detection instead of using pressure sensors. This is an actual prototype installed on LG Nexus 5X. The components divided into two parts, a slidable seat on the front side and phone holder on the back side. As for the front side, we employ an acrylic seat that is held against the backside part with rubber bands at each corner. A piece of conductive tape made of copper is attached at the edge of the seat on the underside, and it is extended to the backside. For the backside, we designed a phone holder with 3D printed materials. The conductive tapes are entirely attached on it so as to touch the user's hand while the user holds the phone. The total material cost for this prototype is much less than $10. Regarding the software implementation, there are a couple of common considerations for applying shear seat. First, to measure shear force, it is necessary for the software to see the displacement of the touch with the conductive tape from the neutral position. In addition, a certain threshold should be set constantly in order to prevent false detection of shear force input when the seat moves a little unintentionally. Finally, since the neutral position and movement limits might change, it is necessary to calibrate them before use. Next, let me introduce the interaction techniques and the application examples achieved by shear seat. Since the shear seat behavior is similar to a joystick, we believe the most promising usage is mapping to rate-based control input. One example is scrolling interface. Our interface extends continuous rate control scrolling on existing flick-based interface. The similar idea can be also applied to drawing on the canvas. As you can see, both drawing and scrolling can be performed without mode switching. Shear force input can be mapped to zooming operation, which offers smooth mode switching between scrolling and zooming with one finger. Shear seat also enables gesture input extension for triggering specific actions. This example shows a gesture to shrink the content in order to reach upper area of the screen. This gesture can be triggered anywhere on the screen. Furthermore, shear seat covers several kinds of multi-finger interaction. This example simultaneously enables both normal touch and shear force input. In this application, the left half of the screen is used for shear force input, which is mapped to character movement, while the right half is used for viewport control. In addition, the form factor of the shear seat is easily customizable. For example, putting multiple conductive parts on the seat further increases the possibilities. This video shows shear force twist interaction that is enabled by detecting two conductive parts. This another example employs multiple seats that individually work on one touch screen. This should be useful when two independent rate-based controls are necessary. Okay. We conducted a user study to explore the benefit and the potentials of the shear seat. In this study, we focus on investigating the performance of a basic off-screen target acquisition of one-dimensional scroll as one of the most promising interactions using shear seat. 12 participants took part in this experiment. The task required the participant to scroll through a text-based document. To complete a trial, participants had to scroll the content, find a red target line, and position it within the blue area. In every technique, both position and rate control operation were offered. First, flick is the most well-used technique, as you can see, and we designed virtual joystick technique to compare the existence of physical feedback with chair seat. The virtual joystick is shown when the user performs long press, and then it can control the scroll speed with visual feedback. With chair seat, the scroll speed can be controlled by the displacement of the seat. Detailed parameter of the behavior can be seen in the paper. We used within participant 3-factorial design, technique, target distance, and target known. Each participant had 96 trials in total. The participants were asked to acquire the target as fast as possible. We did not limit how to operate each technique and how to hold the device. Let's move on to the result. This graph shows the result of the task completion time for each technique relative to target distance. We found chair seat yielded significantly shorter task completion time than virtual joystick, while no significant difference was found between chair seat and flick. Next, this graph shows the number of clutches relative to target distance for each technique. We found that chair seat provided significantly fewer clutches than flick and even less than virtual joystick. We also found that number of clutches with chair seat and virtual joystick was not affected by target distance. We also got NASA TLX score and found that the score increased in the order of chair seat, virtual joystick, and flick. As the most preferable technique, 9 of the participants chose chair seat. In the interview, the participants gave many positive comments on chair seat. The comments included, precise speed control was easy, and the elastic force was comfortable and natural. On the other hand, some participants noted that keeping the seat position steady for a long time was somewhat tiring. In our observation, interestingly, most participants seemed not clearly aware of whether they were using chair or drag with chair seat. This implies that chair interaction was naturally extended to touch interaction. But at the same time, we should note that unintentional shear force detections were sometimes triggered. Therefore, for the general use of chair seat, we suggest that it would be better to assign mutually similar operations to normal touch and shear force input. Our study still contains several limitations. First, regarding our implementation, shear force is detected by the conductive part, which partially disturbs existing touch interaction. We think this problem can be mitigated by considering the way to easily change the location of the conductive part. Another limitation of about physical material properties of the device. Our prototype ignored the durability of the materials, but in the case of commercial use, we have to reconsider the material to improve it. Besides this, we also plan to explore more potential interaction techniques. For example, we will consider unbalancing the stiffness of each rubber band, which provides asymmetric shear force depending on the position of interaction. This is summary of this work. I skip this because of the time. Thank you for attention, and I'm open to questions.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Kazuyuki. A very interesting talk. And are there questions to him? Yes, please. Please do not forget to state your name and affiliation to become acquainted a little bit.
Hello, so I'm Laurent Evin from LMU Munich. I've seen on the video about the joystick conditions that the user use, I think, joystick and flick. So my question is, actually, was the different condition were flick, joystick and flick, and shear and flick? So for fine to reach, like, finally, yeah. So the target?
We think the normal flick, ordinary flick user interface can be divided into the position-based drag operation and the flick gesture, that is a weight-based control. And in the virtual joystick condition, we did not use the flick features, just a position-based drag operation. Do you understand? So,
can you place a video about the joystick condition?
Okay.
So here's the joystick.
If
the here's the flick,
yeah,
right?
If the user performed the flick gesture, the flick does not occur in the virtual joystick condition.
Right. Maybe while you are thinking, just one question in between. You said, of course, that people are a bit disturbed by this conductive piece, whatever, copper plate, whatever you used. And maybe, so where do you, would you like to position it? Because perhaps there is no ideal place at all.
You know, location of
the location of this conductive piece, yeah. Because if you lower it a little bit, then yeah, it might conflict with buttons or so at the bottom, for example.
Yeah. Mm. So I know that location of the conductive part is moved to the another position, which is rarely accessed to the user's finger, but we tested many positions, and we found the lower side of the screen is easy to detect the touch input when the shear force is applied. Yeah. So in our implementation, we use the upper side. So it is kind of my future work.
All right. More questions? Maybe just as a comment of mine, so you might have seen the Joy Holder project also as a demo outside, which is again an attachment of some physical device, a physical joystick to the back of the device, just as an idea. So that we are looking into maybe a new class of accessories you can attach to your mobile phone, either without any electronics or with electronics, as in the case of Joy Holder. So this is maybe an interesting path where you could imagine like an ecosystem of additional gadgets to be attached to your mobile phone, including Shear Sheet.
Yeah.
Right. So if there's no question, let's thank our speaker again. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.